Welcome to the Splunk Education, What's New, and Splunk Enterprise Security 7.2. Before taking this course, students should have a working understanding of Splunk Enterprise Security. We recommend the following courses: Using Splunk Enterprise Security and Administering Splunk Enterprise Security. Let's look at our course objectives. Review the updated panels and data for the risk analysis dashboard. Describe the steps to add multiple drill down searches to a notable event. Illustrate how to add a clickable URL to the next steps in a notable event. Enable the enhanced incident review workflows and review the advanced filters available. Review the new notable event table filters available on incident review. Demonstrate the new incident review timeline and auto refresh feature. Show the new disposition filters in incident review. Create a view in incident review and explain how to share it with ES users. Finally, explain how to require a disposition be set before closing a notable event. This course covers the following topics: Topic 1, Risk Analysis Dashboard Updates. Topic 2, Correlation Search Enhancements, which includes adding multiple drop-down searches to a correlation search and adding a clickable hyperlink to the next steps of a correlation search. Topic 3, Incident Review Advanced Filters, which includes enabling and using advanced filters and using notable table filters. Topic 4, Incident Review Enhancements, which includes timeline, auto refresh, and disposition filters. Topic 5, Creating and Sharing Incident Review Views. And finally, Topic 6, Require Disposition at Close. Our first topic are the updates made to the Risk Analysis Dashboard. The Risk Analysis Dashboard has been updated so users can quickly pivot to the Risk Events Model, the Threat Activity Dashboard, and the MITRE Attack website. For ES environments with Behavior Analytics or BA enabled, there is an index dropdown for choosing the risk or test index, and a new key indicator for BA detections. Here we see the new layout of the Risk Analysis Dashboard and some of the panels that have been updated. Starting at the top is the new index dropdown, which allows you to choose the risk index or the test index. The test index is used to reduce alert volume for behavior analytics detection. You can show panel data from either index. The risk score by object panel has been updated, allowing you to pivot to the risk events model when selecting risk underscore object. The risk events model provides the timeline and details of the risk events that contribute to the risk underscore object. The other panels shown have not changed in 7.2. Scrolling down, we see the rest of the panels. The Risk Modifiers by Annotations panel is now a bar chart instead of a pie chart and shows the number of risk notables by annotation. These are annotations from the top cybersecurity frameworks, including MITRE ATT&CK, CIS, CIS, NIST, NIST, and the Cyber Kill Chain. Selecting a MITRE ATT&CK annotation will redirect you to the details of the annotation on the MITRE ATT&CK website. The Risk Modifiers by Threat Object panel is now a table instead of a pie chart. Select a threat underscore object to open the Threat Activity Dashboard, auto-populated with the object as the threat match value. Our second topic is Correlation Search Enhancements. Let's take a look at the new feature to add multiple drill down searches to a notable via a correlation search. Prior to ES 7.2, the notable adaptive response action allowed the configuration of one drill down search shown here at the top. The drill down search is available in the notable events on the bottom right of the notable details. With ES 7.2, you can add multiple drill down searches to the notable adaptive response action in a correlation search. Select plus add drill down search to add a search. This allows an analyst to quickly narrow the investigation originating from a notable event, thus eliminating the need to manually create queries, saving time, and increasing efficiency. Configure the new drill down, including a name for the drill down, the search, and the earliest and latest offsets. Select plus add drill down search to add another search. Be sure to save the correlation search when finished. The multiple searches are available under the drill down searches in the notable event details. Next, we will look at adding a clickable hyperlink or URL to the next steps of a notable event. A notable event has a next steps section where you can insert an action for an investigator to take, including ping, NS lookup, or add threat intelligence. Now with ES 7.2, you can add a clickable URL as a next step. Next steps are added to the notable adaptive response action in a correlation search. Under the insert action dropdown, choose URL. The example shows adding a next step of clicking the URL for the Lockheed Martin Kill Chain website. The new URL is added to the notable event details under Next Steps, allowing the analyst to easily investigate the Kill Chain framework and how it contributes to the notable event. Next, we'll review the advanced incident review filters available with ES 7.2. ES 7.2 has a new feature called Enhanced Incident Review Workflows available under General Settings. Enabling this feature disables the default incident review filters and moves the filtering to the column headers of the notables list. This new filtering allows you to quickly filter the list of notable events by the various column headers. You can add any field in the notable index as a column header in the table and customize the table by reordering or removing columns. The default view of the incident review has filters across the top of the dashboard. The list of notables changes depending on which filters are chosen. With ES 7.2, you can continue to use these filters or turn on the advanced filters. To enable the advanced filters, navigate to the ES Configure menu and select General, General Settings, and turn on the Enhanced Incident Review Workflows. When enabled, the filters along the top of the Incident Review window are replaced with a keyword search box and a time range picker. The filters are now available on each column headers in the notables list, the timeline, and the chart are still available, though the charts are hidden from the examples shown here. Here we see the filters on each column. You can sort the column alphabetically, search for a keyword, or in some cases, select individual options as shown in the disposition and security domain filters. To customize the column filters, select the gear icon to the right of the table. The table settings allows you to add up to 20 columns to the list. The available column titles on the left are from the fields in the notable index. Select a title to add it to the list. Use the X to remove a column from the list and the double ellipse to reorder the columns. Remember to select Apply to save the changes. Prior to ES 7.2 and the Enhanced Incident Review Workflow option, the Incident Review Table and Event Attributes had separate configurations under Configure, Incident Management, Incident Review Settings. With Enhanced Incident Review Workflows turned on, Table and Event Attributes are merged into one configuration. To revert to the old configuration, simply turn off Enhance Incident Review Workflows under General Settings. Here, you can edit or add the fields and labels used in the Incident Review Notables table. Let's take a look at the other enhancements made to the Incident Review Dashboard in ES 7.2. First, there is the timeline. Analysts can filter the incident review table using a visual timeline, zooming in on anomalous events during a specific time range. You can also remove the timeline from view using the Hide Timeline button in the upper right corner of the dashboard. To use the timeline, select a specific date and time. The blue date and time boxes appear on each side of the selected range. Drag the blue boxes to expand or shrink the selected time range. The timeline then zooms in on the selected time range as shown. Select the deselect button to return to the default timeline. The next feature is the auto refresh. This feature provides the ability to have the list of notables on the incident review dashboard refresh on a given frequency. The frequency can be set to 30 seconds, 1 minute, 2 minutes, or 5 minutes. This feature can be useful in a SOC or Security Operations Center where the dashboard is shown on a large screen to aid analysts in monitoring events and addressing new events in a timely manner. Using auto refresh, the list of results will update without manual intervention. Use the dropdown in the top right corner of the notable list to enable or disable the auto refresh. There is also the option to manually refresh the list without waiting for the refresh interval. When enabled, auto refresh is paused when notables are selected from the list or expanded. The drop-down will display auto refresh off and it will be grayed out. When the notable is unselected or not expanded, auto refresh resumes. Auto refresh is stopped when editing or working with notables. When the notable is opened for editing, a message displays that auto refresh is stopped. Auto refresh is configured under Configure, Incident Management, Incident Review Settings. ES admins can use the Allow Auto Refresh toggle to display or not display the auto refresh option on the incident review dashboard for all users. When disabled, the auto refresh dropdown is not available on the dashboard at all. The default state radio buttons configure the default state of the auto refresh in incident review. This is the default state when a user loads the incident review dashboard, but it can be changed using the auto refresh dropdown menu. By default, the auto refresh is turned off. Finally, the time interval dropdown configures the refresh interval for all ES users. The default interval is 1 minute. Another addition to the incident review dashboard is the ability to filter by disposition. This filter is available as a dropdown at the top of the dashboard when using the default filters, or as a column filter when using the enhanced incident review workflows. Another new feature with ES 7.2 is the ability to create and share views in incident review. Creating and sharing views allows analysts to seamlessly collaborate on notable events, save table filters and column positions into a view for quick visibility into specific kinds of alerts. Once created, you can set a view to be a default view when loading the incident review dashboard. You can then share your views with other ES users to collaborate on investigations. Prior to version 7.2 or on 7.2 without the enhanced incident review workflows enabled, you use the Save New Filters link to create a saved view of the filtered dashboard. You give the filter a name and optionally set it as the default view. These views are just for the current user. Once the views are created, you can use the Saved Filters dropdown to change the view or manage the saved filters. When managing the filters, you can only change the default view or delete a view. With the enhanced incident review workflows available in ES 7.2, Not only do you get the advanced dashboard filterings, as we saw earlier, but you also get the ability to create new dashboard views and share them with other users. Once you have filtered and arranged the dashboard, select Save. In the Save View window, give the view a name and select the following settings as needed. Set as Default, which sets the view as the default for the current user. Share with all Enterprise Security users, which makes the view available under Saved Views for all ES users. Views are available under Saved Views dropdown. You can easily see which view is the default, which is the current view, shown with a check mark, and which views are shared, shown with a people icon. To change the current view, select it from the list. To edit a view, select Manage Saved Views. Use the pencil icon to edit the view or the trash icon to delete the view. Let's take a look at our final topic, Require Disposition at Close. A new setting, available in version 7.2, is the ability to acquire a disposition be selected before an analyst can save an in status for a notable event and incident review. To configure this option, navigate to Configure, Incident Management, Incident Review Settings, and scroll to the bottom of the page. Under Incident Review Dispositions, toggle the Required button to require adding a disposition when choosing an in status for a notable event. By default, the in status for notable events is closed. An ES admin can change the in status under Configure, Incident Management, Status Configuration. If you try to set the status of a notable to closed and save the changes without selecting a disposition, other than undetermined, the error shown displays. Select a disposition, other than undetermined, from the dropdown and select Save Changes. The key topics we have covered in this course have been the updated panels and information in the Risk Analysis Dashboard, how to add multiple drill-down searches to a notable event, how to add a clickable hyperlink to the next steps in a notable event, turning on the enhanced incident review workflows and the advanced filters that are available, the new column filters available for the notable table in the incident review, how to use the incident review timeline, using the incident review auto-refresh feature, filtering incident review notables by disposition, creating and sharing an incident review with all ES users, and how to acquire disposition be set before closing a notable event. If you are interested in taking any of Splunk's Enterprise Security courses, please visit the training and certification page on splunk.com. If you are interested in becoming a Splunk Enterprise Security Certified Administrator, please visit the Splunk certification page on splunk.com. Thank you very much for attending this course and finding out what's new in ES 7.2.